text. In verse number 17, Psalm 68 from verses 17 down from 20. You have it, say amen. Hallelujah. It reads, the chariots of God are 20,000, even thousands of angels. The Lord is among them and is as in Sinai in the holy place. Thou hast ascended on high. Thou hast led captivity captive. Thou hast received gifts for man, yea, for the rebellious also, that the Lord God might dwell among them. Blessed be the Lord who daily loadeth us with benefits, even the God of our salvation. He that is our God is the God of salvation. Unto God, the Lord, belongeth the issues from death. Clap your hands for the reading of the word of the Lord. Proverbs chapter 17, verse number 8, very familiar passage of scripture. Proverbs 17 and verse number 8, it says, the gift is as a precious stone in the eyes of him that hath it. Whithersoever he turneth, it prospereth. I want to talk this morning for a few minutes about God gave gifts unto man. Now, before he gave gifts unto man, the Bible said that he ascended on high, and he first received the gifts. You can't give something that you don't have. And Jesus came and he ascended on high. The Bible said that he received gifts on the men. For men. Not for the righteous. But according to the Bible, it says for the rebellious and for the wicked. A lot of times we try to see how much God can do things for us because of how righteous we are, or how holy, or how in good standing we are with God. But the Bible said, while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Amen. God is not just looking for somebody who's holy and who's righteous, or somebody who's perfect. But he's looking for somebody that would believe on him. He's looking for somebody that it doesn't matter what they've done or what they've been through or what people have said about them. He's reaching out, hallelujah, to somebody that's been rejected. He's reaching out to somebody that's been oppressed, somebody that's been cast out, somebody that's been, you know, right off as people think they should have been. He said right here, God gave gifts onto the rebellious. You know, we look at people in the world and say, look at that person, you know, they're a gangster, drug addict, crack addict, alcoholic, backslidden, fornicator, adulterer. We can find all things wrong with people because of their situation or their condition. But these are the people, hallelujah, that Jesus came to search for. Glory to God. We were not always in church. We were not always righteous. We were not always holy and sanctified and filled with the Holy Ghost and talking in tongues and know how to praise God. But praise God, the Bible said, God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. Not for the righteous. He said, for the righteous man, one would dare to die. But he said, while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. So the gifts of God is given to men, not just the Christians. But he said he gave gifts unto man. And that's not just talking about a gender, not just talking about a man as a physical, masculine person. But the gifts of God is given to men and women. But you know what? Something about a gift, you can't just take a gift. You have to be able to receive a gift. People now can buy themselves gifts because nobody's going to give them a gift. Hallelujah. But there's nothing like when somebody gives you a gift. A gift is priceless. Hallelujah. The Bible said it's like a precious stone. It doesn't matter. Praise God. When a person go to buy that gift, if they go to the dollar store or they find it on sale or at an auction, a gift is priceless. You can put a price on a gift when somebody gives you a gift. Praise God. There's a value on a gift that you yourself yourself. God, hallelujah, he's chosen you.
Yeah.
He's chosen you to do what? To put gifts inside of you, not just to make you great or to make you somebody special, but the Bible said he gave us those gifts so that he may dwell among men. By revelation or by the scripture.